Let's keep this good news coming, shall we?
Yeah, this feels like a dream. And you know just what I mean. You see my boy, he like gotta made it, gotta made it. Boy, he's a fan and he like the Ravens, like the Ravens.
So YouTube team, keep it clean. What's going on? It's Engraven here with another video. And in this video, there was just a lot of good news that we got yesterday. Well, actually today, but when you see this video, it will have been yesterday. But anyway, that's beside the point. But this news was also sprinkled in with all the good news that we received. And this was about Ronnie Stanley and his injury update, because we've all been wondering, like, what's going on with Ronnie Stanley? We know he's been out of practice for the longest, and they expect him to be out for a little while, but they didn't put him on injury reserve. So could he be back sooner rather than later? What's going on? But we got an update from one Ian Rappaport. But before we get into this, team, keep it clean. I love y'all. I love y'all, and I appreciate y'all. One thing that I appreciate y'all about y'all the most is, and I saw this yesterday, is that y'all got my back, man. Y'all really do. And that's what I feel like with Team Keep It Clean. It's like it's family, man. Y'all like extended family, and I appreciate that. I appreciate that we can get on here, and we, of course, talk Ravens, but a lot of times we just talk in life, man, because a lot of things that need some lessons that we learn and some different things that apply to football, they also apply in life as well. And one thing that's very, very important to know, especially when it comes to like the players and the coaches and everybody that's involved with the whole business of the NFL, you got to remember that no matter how you feel about somebody, no matter how you feel about a decision that they've made, no matter how you feel about their play, they are people too. They are human beings too. They have families just like you do. They have jobs just like you do. They got kids just like you do. They got wives just like you do. They got mothers, sisters, brothers, fathers, everything just like you do. Their job's a little different than ours, and they make a little more money, but they're human beings at the end of the day. So always keep that in mind. But I love y'all. Anyway, and shout out to the Team Keep It Clean patrons. I can't give a shout out to everybody without giving a shout out to the patrons. But anyway, we've been talking enough. Ian Rappaport, he reported that, and let's just read it verbatim. He said, following a visit this week to the doctor to check in on his ankle, Ravens All-Pro left tackle Ronnie Stanley will continue to rehab for a couple weeks with hopes of returning sooner rather than later, a source said. Now, that wasn't even the best news. Because he's obviously been rehabbing because he hasn't been playing. So, and he's been wanting to get better. So we would all assume that he was rehabbing and he was resting and whatnot. So that wasn't even the big news, at least in my opinion. That's good news, but that wasn't the good news. This was it right here. No surgery is planned, just rehab. And that's big, because that lets us know that the injury is not a super long-term injury and that it can be healed without the surgery. Because, you know, with surgery, it cleans it up. It'll get it right. It'll get it fixed. But it'll also take that player out for an extended amount of time. And a lot of times a much longer amount of time than if something that can be rehabbed would just be rehabbed. So that's a very, very good sign for the Ravens and Ronnie Stanley. So now it's just a waiting game. I mean, as it always has been, it's the waiting game. One thing about Ronnie Stanley throughout his career, he has been pretty banged up. He plays in more games than he misses, but I think like every year that he's missed at least one game, I believe. Now, with that being said, Deshaun Elliott the other day, I love how he put it because it's true. He said, for all the people that be talking about, oh, players injury prone and players always getting hurt, this and that, he said, do you think we go out there and we want to be hurt? Do you think we want to get injured? And it's just like, it makes sense. And I mean, the same thing. And us as fans, we look at things differently, obviously. We're not looking from the player's perspective. But I know fans, we can be frustrated like, oh, man, this guy's always hurt. He's always injured. But again, they are human beings. Things happen. That's something we always got to keep in mind. Always. Now, the Ravens, they had a presser yesterday that featured John Harbaugh. I missed his part. I don't know how. It also featured Chuck Clark. That's why I came in it. I saw that. Featured Lamar Jackson and Calais Campbell. Now, I did catch Lamar Jackson's part. The rest of them, I was sort of in and out, so I can't really speak on those. But Lamar Jackson, he was asked about Teddy Bridgewater. He said that's his boy. He said Teddy Bridgewater used to come back to Louisville a couple times, but they didn't really get to chop it up back then. But he said that's his boy now. So that's always a good thing. And, of course, they also got that South Florida connection that y'all already know. Ryan Mink asked about the offense having led go-ahead drives in every game this year so far. And that's something that we talked about, too. That is so significant, the fact that the Ravens have done it literally in every single game. They have gotten the lead in the fourth quarter of those games and put the defense in a position to close it out. Now, in a couple of those games, well, the Lions game was a little bit different. But in the Raiders game, again, there was 32 seconds left. Lamar Jackson, Ravens offense, Gator defense, they say, hey, these boys got 32 seconds left and no timeouts. Defense, go ahead and do y'all thing. We know y'all been struggling all game, but go ahead and close it out. Nope. But then they got the go-ahead touchdown against the Chiefs. And, of course, Odafe Owe, he made the great play where he knocked the ball out and recovered it. Again, no such thing as luck, and Odafe Owe showed you just that. Because a lot of Chiefs say, oh, it's luck. No, it wasn't luck. There's no such thing. That was just skill and will. And then, of course, with the Lions, all that drama. Anyway, so that's a good thing. Because some people, they've been doubting Lamar Jackson if he got that clutch factor or not. And he's been showing you. So that's been nice. Anyway, Lamar said he isn't surprised that he's leading the league in whatever stats. He said the only thing that he's worried about is winning. And that has just been a reoccurring statement for Lamar Jackson. It's the only thing he cares about is winning. And we know that because his stats, they're not always the prettiest. Now, on just past Sunday, they should have been a lot prettier. But we love you, Hollywood. You know we do. We know Hollywood's going to bounce back. And Lamar said the same thing, too, because he was asked about Hollywood. He was asked about, what's going on with Hollywood, what happened with Hollywood, how you feel about Hollywood, how you going to get him back to having a strong game. He said, is Hollywood going to be fine? He said he ain't worried about Hollywood. Somebody asked him about how they, even on Marlon Humphrey, his IG live, his victory IG live. It was always nice to have those. They talked about how he showed Lamar and Hollywood sitting next to each other. He's like, yeah, that's my brother. And we all know that. They both from the crib. Anyway, we ain't got to get to that. But when they were on the plane, they just came off a win, and they sitting there watching film together. And somebody that I talked to, they were like, man, see, this is what I'm talking about. That's a leader right there. That's the leader of this team right there. Just came off a win. Like, a lot of guys will come off of a loss, and they'd be like, this is what we need to do better. Okay, this is what we need to know. They just came off a win, and a win like that, you're supposed to be celebrating. You're supposed to be like, oh, yeah, hey, bow the whole bar. We celebrating Justin Tucker for what he did. Oh, yeah, doing all that stuff. Sitting there watching film. You leaving Detroit where y'all just, you watching film. That's great, and that's not something to be underestimated. And it's not like Lamar Jackson is the only quarterback that does it. But it speaks volumes that he's doing just that. He also talked about in OTAs, because somebody asked about the deep ball. He said in OTAs they were working on the deep ball a lot, and he's hopeful to hit a lot more throughout the season. And of course, we definitely are. We're hopeful that he continues to hit those deep balls just like he did against the Lions literally all day. All day. Now, of course, we want them to be caught, but also with the expectation. We can't expect him every deep ball, every deep pass that he throws, it's not going to be a completion. Every deep pass that he throws is not going to be on the money. That's life as a quarterback. That's life as an NFL player. So, anyway, he was also asked what he's seen this year as far as growth from himself. He said he's not focused on that. He said he don't be, like, over-critiquing himself or anything like that. He just said he wants to win. Again, same thing. So we've been hearing this from Lamar from jump, before he even put on a jersey. That's all he talked about. He just want to win. That's it. He just want to win. He talked about Rashad Bateman, about him coming back. Because this was before practice. He said that Bateman is a great route runner with strong hands, and he said that he knows that Bateman will be hungry and ready when his time comes. Oh, yeah, and we know that for sure. And we saw, like, clips of Rashad Bateman and Miles Boykin running and stuff. And, again, it's just practice, but it's nice to see them out there. So we hope that they when they are finally implemented into the offense, and that's another thing, too, something that I was confused on earlier but got clarification on it, that they have been activated from injury reserve, but they're not on the active roster yet. Because I know that was really tricky. It was tricky for me. I know it's been tricky for some other people, though. But they are not on the 53-man roster yet. Not yet. But they have to be activated to the 53-man roster within the next 21 days. So just a little heads up with that. And also he talked about how when he was speaking to Hollywood and they were going over film, he said they were just focusing on the things that they got to hit on. Just the fixing the mistakes, correcting errors, fixing any issues, and so on and so forth. So that's just that leader mentality, man. And something with this team, I know I talked to my guy JT about it a lot. Something with this team that has really been affecting them the past couple of years, especially come playoff time, what it seems like is just mentality. Like there's a lack of focus when it's crunch time. You can see it on the field. Sometimes you can even hear it in their voices when they have the presses and whatnot. But there would just be a lack of focus. But so far, so good this year. I mean, again, they just got to clean up some stuff. But it's really nice to know that the stuff that they need to clean up, it's all fixable. It's all fixable. It's nothing where it's like, oh man, this ain't nothing that they can work on this year. They gotta wait till next year to fix it. No, it's all simple stuff that they can fix right here and right now. It's just a matter of time with getting it done. Anyway, team, keep it clean. I love y'all. Again, I appreciate y'all so much for riding with us, man. Thank you, and we out.